Hello everybody and welcome to hopefully the finale of Mega Man on NES. And in the last episode we got through the second and third, I can't remember. Second and third Wily stage, and in this episode we're hopefully going to make it through the fourth one. I really hope we do, because if not, then that's going to really suck. Alright. No, I didn't want to collect that at the magnet beam. Oh, man. Alright, well. I'm gonna use Cutman's weapon here, because it's the only one like that launches at an angle like that. And, ooh, nice. Some life there. Whoa, okay. Slow down. And then instant death spikes. Okay, now we want to wait for the platform. Now, what would a platform? Oh! That's what I get for referencing Bubsy. Alright. Ooh, shoot. Now, I don't know where the checkpoints are in this level. I do know, though, that we have to refight. Four of the other four robot masters in this stage, which is something that I'm not really wanting to do. Okay. I wanted to get the Electbeam charged up, even though I don't really need it, because Iceman only takes three shots, but yeah, it's nice to have, you know. Oh, crap. Ah, dang it. Jumped right into it. Shoot. Alright. Let's try that again. Let's see. There we go. And then we want to hop up here. Oh, shoot! My gosh. Alright, let's not freaking do that again. Alright. But at least in a good sort of way, we got our weapons refilled, so. It ain't too bad. Not ideal, but not too bad. Hopefully, though, I don't get launch into the spikes again. I might just have to use the magnet beam, actually. Oh, not have to, but I might just use it just to make it easier. Alright. I like that little I almost slipped right off. I was gonna say, I like that little effect that Mega Man does whenever you unpause the game. It's really neat. Okay, I'll be right back. Okay, we made it here. Now, I'm gonna wait for this platform to go back to the right over here, because we not only got a 1 up there, it's not what I'm interested in the most though. What I want the most is that thing. That's an Ashichi, which it refills everything, life and everything. I don't really want the 1 up, because, I mean, there's no checkpoints either way. So, you know. Okay, the first boss is gonna be Bomb Man. This is where the boss refights start. And then here's gonna be Bomb Man. Okay, you really want to not get hit by him, because oh shoot, as soon as I say don't, you don't want to get hit by him. Crap. You do. Not doing a very good job of not getting hit by him, that's for sure. Ugh, God, that is not great. So yeah, this is basically a gauntlet between Fireman, Iceman, Gutsman, and Bombman, which, oh gosh. Yep. Definitely difficult. So I'm just probably going to speed up and play music until I'm able to beat them. And since I don't really want to subject you to me doing that, so let's go. After I die. Okay, phew. Alright, I'm not gonna lie to you guys, I used the pause trick there because yikes! It's definitely a gauntlet, I'll tell you that much. And here we have the final boss of the game, which is Dr. Wily. Now if I game over here, then I'm just gonna cut to this part of the fight again, because you guys don't need to see the rest of that part. What you wanna do is use the fire. He's really weak to it. He doesn't do that much damage. And then he's gonna have a second phase here. Now, what you wanna do is get kinda like around here with him. He's gonna shoot this power ball there. It's gonna go in like a really weird circly pattern, but if you stand like this distance away, it won't actually hurt you. It'll go right around you. So, yeah, you just wanna stand kinda under him and then just spam the Elec Beam. And then once you're out of Elec Beam, well, he's also really weak to Cut Man. Boom! And that is Dr. Wily. And then he bows down to us. Phew! And yeah, that was, in the words of Scott, we'll eventually take a look at the first Mega Man Wozniak. That was the first Mega Man, all right. It was actually kind of fun revisiting this classic. Like I said, it's kind of saddening to see that the Blue Bomber is kind of losing relevancy in the modern gaming world. But it's always nice to go back to these games. These games, well, they're really, really, really hard sometimes. Oddly enough, it's the fun kind of hard, you know? Like, it's not Mario Bros. 2 or Ghosts and Goblins or. I wouldn't say Zelda 2 is that hard, but yeah, it's not like those games, you know? It's a very challenging. It does its best to be fair, although there are some points in some games that are kind of cheap, which I will make note of those when it comes to later. This game, the boss rush, is probably the lowest it gets. I would honestly have a really hard time with that boss rush if I wasn't able to use the pause trick, and I almost did make it a few times without using the pause trick, but then I decided that it was taking way too long without it, so I just wanted to go ahead and, you know, just get the game over with. Which is not to say that I don't like the game, it's just that boss rush is a little bit too difficult for me. Well, it's not, because I've done it legitimately before, it's just I just don't have the time like I used to, man. But yeah, that was a fun romp through the first Mega Man game. I will be playing, like I said, all the other classic Mega Man games. And oh well, there's Roll and Dr. Light. I don't think I've mentioned them before at all in this series. Basically, Dr. Light created Mega Man. He's awesome. And Roll is our little sister. And Mega Man's real name is Rock. Because, you know, rock and roll, you know, music. But, yeah, that was definitely the first Mega Man. If you press start, you come back to this screen, which the... is all the Robot Masters defeated and Dr. Wily accessible again, but I'm obviously not going to do that. I'm instead going to end this episode off here, and next time, I'll see you back here in another time, in another space. Okay, see you guys next time.